Hello and welcome back to Pro League. We just saw the first game between NYM and Aware, which ended 3-2 in favour to Aware. Now, I did have Brycey with me, but he has gone and done other devices, and now a wild Trout has appeared. Welcome, Trout.
Thank you for having me. I'm filling in for Brycey as he had to go and catch a train, but we are here with myself and Calvin to watch the Epsilon versus SK game, as we know the TCM Vitality game, which I think everyone was kind of really looking forward to, is unfortunately not going to be aired today because TCM unfortunately having to forfeit due to not enough players able to play. But we'll just have to make do and hope that this game is an absolute stellar performance.
Yeah, but it's Epsilon versus SK. Both teams have a win on the board. So one team here is going to go 1-for-1, while the other could go top of the table. And on map difference, they will go number 1, poised to go above Aware. And we're going to start on board with Epsilon Jerd.
I think, you know, when this Pro League started, we didn't expect Aware and SK to be right at the top of the table. It's still early doors and anything could change, but they are really taking the games by the scruff of the neck and going forward for it. So Aware already with two wins under their belt. Let's see if SK can pull back a win, but against Epsilon, they wouldn't be my favourites going up against Epsilon.
I'm going to see how SK do here. I expect them to give Epsilon a really good game. Madcap getting first blood. Quickie and Rots answer back with kills onto Jerd and the Madcap. We're on board with Swanee, who gets a kill onto Matt Millitz, but he gets taken down by Quickie. Quickie swings around and cleans up Shane, and we got SK all over B.
Beautiful play by Quickie there. He is just sweeping around these trains to see if he can pick up another kill. Does pick up Jerd there. He's 4-0 right now as he's locking down this B flag with his teammates. Not quite aware that one of them is coming around the backside. Does pick up another kill on Shane. That's 5-0 now. Going to finally be shut down by Swanee. Swanee actually picking up two kills there. It's time for Epsilon to make a move and cap this flag. But Kivi following up on the death of Quickie. Does pick up a second on Jerd as well. And it's Epsilon just a little bit sluggish getting out of the stocks.
Yeah, Epsilon are very sluggish. Yeah, that's 11-16, early days yet. But you can see that Quickie, Pete and Kivi are making a really big nuisance on themselves. Rocks chipping in with the kills there. Shane just gets a Semtex onto Quickie, and Madcap takes down McMillitz. So you should, if you look at the minimap, you should see Epsilon looking to make that B push now. Rocks is not going to let that happen, however.
Absolutely. Rocks just checking the B flag. Someone does pick up the kill eventually. I believe it was, in fact, McMillitz. Rocks picking up a kill on Madcap. He's just trying to keep them locked into the C flag now. Is he going to pick up Shane? No, Shane shuts him down. Kivi's going to go down with him. McMillitz picks up a kill in answer on Swanee. Jerd picking up McMillitz. And Quickie coming around the backside trying to pick up that A flag. As the flags have rotated, Epsilon do pick up the B flag in amongst all of that. Shane's going to get killed by Quickie. Madcap with that flawless sub that he talks so highly about. Let's see what he can do. He's trying to pick up kills. Does eventually pick up Quickie. He's 5-2 right now. He's going to jump on the train. He knows that someone else is probably going to come through that doorway at some point as they all spawn at the back of this building.
Yeah, Madcap loves to say that he runs a flawless sub, Trout.
He just died there.
But the sub weren't that flawless in that case. But we're on board with Swanee, and he is up in top three. He's going to be the one just putting down shots onto SK players. I have a look into fully tagged them up, will kill them. And as you can see, just shoots long rays, gets a few shots. I think Jerd cleaned that one up. And he's just overseeing B. And as you can see, 36-31. So the point tally has turned over. It looks in Epsilon's favour now. And we got 2 minutes 30 left on the clock.
Absolutely. Swanee in a nice little vantage point in that building. However, there was a moment where he couldn't quite see one of the players taking the flag, and he relied on one of his teammates. So if they all go down at the same time, it could be that they end up losing that B flag because Swanee's not in a great position to actually make that challenge and get the kill that he needs to stop it. We're on board with Swanee right now, who he is 7-5 with one capture. Madcap just going to jump on the B flag to make sure if anyone does come and try and contest it. He's got a good look on those crates over on the left-hand side. His teammates actually losing the C flag. It has been neutralized, and one of the SK players actually backing off, just baiting him out, and Rox does pick up that kill. Great play by him to just distract him enough to bring him right back out of the action. Shane as well has been drafted from the back. Let's see if he can pick up his kill. He does eventually shut down Rox, and he's going to try and pick up that C flag in return.
Yeah, Shane played an excellent game of cat and mouse there, and he did come up on top, and he is uncontested on C flag. He does get it, and you can just look at the other side of the map. Jerd is there trying to pick up A. Can he win this gunfight? Yes, he does. So he should be able to get A. Free cap is now in session. SK are being overrun.
Absolutely. Jerd playing fantastic right now. He has struggled recently with this game, considering his internet connections to the rest of the players can be a little bit flaky at times, and he has got quite frustrated, as well as the whole Epsilon lineup not really being playing at the best online because of that connection disadvantage. but they do have a fantastic game when it does come to LAN.
Yeah, they do. Players like Shane, as you know, online, he gets torn inside out by some teams that he feels that he should never be ever losing to. Goes to LAN, gives them the treatment, so I think he's pretty content. But we're going to get back into the game. As you can see, SK are losing C. They can't get anywhere near B right now. Whoever that was near Rox was giving him a massive headache, and he's just been slain there by Jerd. Got a headshot. We're on board with Milix, only player alive, as I was saying, that just on the ground. He's got four Epsilon players to contend with. There's one, and it's Epsilon Madcat who just takes him down. 83 to 53, 30 seconds left on the clock.
Absolutely. It looks like SK just can't seem to get out of this spawn lock they found themselves in. Freight, one of those maps that you can really be punished if you do let the B flag go to the opposition and you can't get out of that flag, out of the back spawns. But Kivi and Quickie making a dash for the B flag, and they do in fact pick it up, so they can start to get some points on the board. Unfortunately, there's only 11 seconds left, so a little bit of a late push for them. Madcat's going to get taken down by Milix. Can he turn? No, Swanee's going to pick that one up. You do not want a one-on-one gun battle with Swanee, and it looks like Kivi just shooting the dead body out of a little bit of frustration there, but it looks like Epsilon going to go into the second half with a 30-point lead.
Yep, 91 to 61. I don't know what you're shooting at, Kivi, because you are 30 points down. So we're going to wait for this side to just finish off here, bring up the stat board. As you can see, Madcat 14-7, Jerd 13-9, Swanee 14-9, Shane 8-10. But all it matters is that you get the points on the board on this side, and each player has got a capture respectively.
Absolutely. So we're going to start the second half. You're new to competitive Call of Duty for Domination. It is a game of two halves. One team will start on one half, another will start on the other side, and they will play one game of 5 minutes, then play once again for 5 minutes on opposite halves to make it all fair and even, and the accumulative score will be tallied up, and that will decide the winner. And Epsilon have a rocking 30-point lead right now. It's going to take quite a lot for SK to come back. What do you reckon SK need to do differently this half to try and bring back that deficit?
I dare say this is Epsilon's strongest Domination map. I watched them play MYM on it,
yeah,
and Shane was having a ball of the time when he was in the studio, and the way that Epsilon play this is really diabolical. You can see this is the side they started on. They consider this side the weaker side. Mm. And what you'll be looking out for them to do is to really get aggressive. They're going to take B. You'll see someone like Madcat aggressively try and get through. Like,
there he goes.
Yeah,
again.
Look at that. Two down so far, because Madcat actually got a shot onto Shane. Mm. And they've taken B. You should aim to see them try and flip the spawn so that SK spawn where they did on the first side. And that's where Epsilon are strongest, and they'll like to lock them in there.
Absolutely. It's a lot more difficult to get out of that side of the half of the map because there's far less directions to move through. But Madcat doing a great job this half. He is 3-0. Remember picking up that team kill on Shane at the beginning. Could have been 4-0 had he managed to pick up a kill on an enemy. Is he going to pick up this kill? He does on Quickie. He's 4-0 right now, having a rampage. Oh, doesn't manage to get Kivi in that. And Kivi's going to shut him down. We're going to jump on board with Jerd to try and pick up that revenge kill. He's 3-1 right now. Going to get shut down by Rox, trailing behind Swanee, lying on the floor as he usually does. Madcat right up in the center of it once again. Actually switching to an SMG for this game, it seems like. Because of the Epsilon lineup, Swanee just such an amazing AR that Madcat has decided to go with the submachine gun. And he is having a great, great time using that submachine gun. I wouldn't say it's quite as flawless as he likes to boast, but it's certainly, certainly near that.
Yeah, certainly near that. He just saw an SK player. Milix just neutralized that A flag. Madcat tried to go and get it back, but that's not happening. But can you see that Epsilon now finally tried to retake
Absolutely.
C and force SK to spawn at A? There's a Epsilon player that got taken down there. That was Jerd trying to take C, but all of SK have been cleared out of their original spawn, and now they're going to be spawning by A, and the disadvantage is on their side right now. Epsilon will be looking to just force them further back into A spawn.
Yep. Shane up on that top building. I'm not sure what he was looking to gain from there. It's a bit of a hospital situation for him. He's not got much he could do with an MTAR. It's a good gun, but I don't think it's going to be that good at that height and range. Very interesting to see that a lot of these guys not actually using the tracker sight that I've seen becoming quite a trend in most people because of that so-called no recoil iron sights and the tracker sight that gives you such advantage not only at range for a submachine gun but gives you the tracking through the smoke. So what do you reckon the trend of this is? Why do you think that these guys are not choosing to use it yet?
They're running really aggressive classes here. They've probably got a load of nades. It's just something they don't see as really important right now. how many times have we seen a smoke go down on this map, really?
And very true.
And the players have noticed that and probably just adjusted to it. But on board with Rocks, trying to take B here through the smoke. He's got Kibby to back him up. And it looks like SK are going to get B flag. And they are now got two caps to to Epsilon's one there. But still, 35 to 30, 37 to 60. The lead is going to get cut down a little bit. But you've got to remember that Epsilon have a 30-point lead over SK.
Absolutely. They are 23 points down in this half, actually. Well, they were 23. It looks like it's now going to be 20 points plus the 30 from the previous half. So they're down by 50 points. They got a minute 45 to bring it back. And I think only realistically a two and a neutral or a free cap is going to benefit SK at this point in time, as Shane's doing some amazing work in the spawn of the SK lineup as they manage to pick up the C flag. They're going to make a move to the B flag. They do see one man on the A flag. That's going to be another man down for the SK lineup. Surely they're going to make a push for the B flag and see this game out.
Yeah, Shane just building up a little street there. Gets taken down by Kivy eventually. Going to jump back with Jerd. He gets shut down by Quickie, waiting for the respawn. Just going to hang on with Swanny. He's 8-5, three captures to his name. Predicted Kivy coming around the corner there, but was unable to get the kill. And SK are going to be looking to take a flag from Epsilon.
It's quite interesting. It looks like they're not that concerned with going for the B flag. They're more concerned with just keeping
free
one.
Free cap is now in session.
Oh, this could have backfired on them. It looked like they were just content with picking up one flag for themselves and neutralizing another one. That way they could just pretty much split up the team, and they didn't even need to cap the B flag. They just kept them busy and keeping them out of the points with this massive score that they actually have in their favor. And it's still in their favor right now, as they're 15 points up with 30 seconds left plus the 30. I think the Epsilon have done a stellar job in just pretty much shifting the focus from the B flag to one of the A or C flags for the SK lineup, in which they didn't really know what to do. They had to split up, and it completely allowed people like Shane and Jerd to get up in there and disrupt them as much as possible.
Yeah, when B's not really going too well for you, you've got to focus on other flags, but that means more time running across the map, more chances of being seen by the enemy and being shot. And yeah, it's just worked in against SK. They're 77 to 84. And if you just do the point total there, Trout got plus 7 in favor of Epsilon, plus their plus 30 earlier. So they're going to win that plus 37, and they're going to go 1-0 up in the series.
Absolutely. Great play by Epsilon right there. SK not really having much to answer back. They had incredibly good scores in the first half, just not the domination score to back it up. But that's going to be 1-0 to Epsilon in the series. We'll be right back after this commercial with some Search and Destroy. Don't go anywhere. We'll see you in a little bit. Hello and welcome back to the GFinity Pro League. My name is Chris Trout, aka the Trout 91, and I'm joined by the beautiful Calvinus.
Oh, thank you.
Don't worry about it.
You're too kind.
No, you shouldn't say that about yourself. You're a lovely, beautiful human being, and I thought you needed to be appreciated. But anyway, moving on with the Call of Duty action right now. We're back with Epsilon versus SK Gaming. It's 1-0 in the series to Epsilon. They took the domination in very comfortable fashion. We've got some Search and Destroy and Sovereign action going on. One of my personal favourite Search and Destroy maps.
Yeah, Sovereign's a favourite of mine now. You'll see that some teams are not comfortable going to A, not comfortable in winning long-range gunfights. So they try and get to B, try and get up close and personal. So we'll just see how these teams counteract each other, really. See what team favours what bomb. And we're going to jump on with Swanny. He's got a hybrid sight on his gun, so he can do both thermal and his red dot at any time. Let's just see how he plays this, really. He's got all three players of his team getting aggressive there. Oh, God.
Jerd has got the bulldog out.
Jerd got the bulldog out. Kivy got up. Well, there's another victim of the bulldog. That would be Quickie. So that's two kills for Jerd straight off the bat. I was going to say Shane got a knife dead early going into that B bomb site. But Jer was there to back him up. Gets two kills. He's just sneaking around with the Bulldog, looking for a third victim. 55 seconds left on the clock, and he is the bomb carrier as well.
It's actually really forgotten about in some circumstances, the fact that we do have shotguns enabled, and they are very handy in stuff like this. I remember just before Flux went to MLG Columbus, he was asking me about shotguns and what I thought the best shotgun was, and I was like, the Bulldog is by far the best shotgun to probably use. And he said, alright, it looks like I've got a little surprise to show MLG Columbus. And I think he did bring it out during that contest. I didn't personally see it, but I imagine it went fairly well for him. They did a great job at MLG, and TCM have been putting in such time and effort that it would be a shame if they didn't get anything more than they've already got out of this entire thing. I mean, they're one I-50. I expect far more championships with the lineup that they've got going in through Ghosts.
Yeah. If you looked at the setup there, both both Madcat and Swanee moved very far back from the bomb site. They're confident in their long-range aim, and Milix was just running around the perimeter constantly looking for them, and no one was home. And eventually that just left him exposed to Swanee's AR, and he got picked apart. So 1-0 to Epsilon, and we're going to get on with Madcat.
Absolutely. Swanee just in an incredible position to watch the bomb with that thermal, and it was up to one of the SK members to pick up two kills in that time. Just not really a good idea for him to really, you know, go straight for the bomb defuse. He's got to look around and try and find them, and he couldn't find them. Didn't expect them to be that far away, but with Swanee, you know he's going to put himself in such an advantage point with an assault rifle. And we are on board with Shane. He's just outside that B flag. We see Kivi is on B flag, the B bomb site. Kivi's actually on the opposite stairs, and Swanee's sitting at the back, just making sure no one sweeps behind. Kivi just once again checking no one comes up the stairs in case something does happen. Shane's actually got two grenades on. If I'm honest, he's chucked those out pretty early on in the round. He's still got 50 seconds left, and it looks like Kivi and co. are going to actually try and make a bomb plant.
Yeah, now that both grenades have been thrown, Kivi will think that's free reign to go get a plant down. But Jerd is very close. He should be able to see that player drop down. Oh, how is he? Oh, he should have really got that kill there. Unfortunately, Jerd gets shut down by Kivi, and now it is up to Shane, who is closest in that range. And there you go. There's the ADS sight, laser sight from Swanee. Gets a kill onto Quiggy. Milix gets a kill onto Madcat, and that's it. That's a player jumping around the corner. Epsilon Shane gets the kill. He's looking for the next player. Rox gets around that corner with the MTAR, gets the kill. And now he really needs to make a plant here.
Absolutely.
But I think he is just out of time.
No, I think he might get it.
Ooh, oh, yes, he does.
Just in the nick of time.
I was thinking defuse timer there, but plant timer is 5 seconds. So now it's Rox v Swanee.
What's Swanee going to do? He's got an AR in a very difficult position right now. He's just looking around. What's he going to do? No, surely he's not going to go for the defuse.
Yes, he's going to go for the early defuse, unless if you look at the timer, he is
Rox
going
is
to
nowhere.
Get it. Rox is nowhere to be seen, and there we go.
Swanee!
The fuse has gone down. Swanee puts his team 2-0 up, gets both round-ending plays there, and it was a nice play by Swanee.
Absolutely.
You find with most players now, they think that it always has to be done in the last second, and it doesn't, really. And sometimes getting an early defuse does pay off.
I completely agree. I've said this many a times. You think the situations where people have been looking around the bomb trying to find that final kill just so they can get the defuse off, when really in that time it's taken them to look around and find someone, they could have got the defuse off. And Swanee just thinking, you know what, I'm probably not going to get this defuse unless I go for it now. Tries his luck, and you know, if you don't buy a ticket, you never win the lottery. And it looks like Swanee has definitely won the lottery there. And they put themselves 2-0 up in the Surge Destroy. Looks like Shane, Madcat, and Jerd have rushed this B-bomb site in a very similar fashion to the rest of the rounds that we have played so far.
Well, if you're going to compare it to the lottery, what did Swanee win? The grand prize of a bomb defuse. Quickie gets the first shot onto Jerd. He's got first blood for his team. And now they're going to need to pick a candidate to put down that bomb. It's very risky business, considering if you do go down and try and put it down, you may get sniped by Quickie. But Shane's there. He gets the bomb. He has to try and plant now.
He has been stunned, so they're probably aware of his presence in that room, but they're not thinking he's going to plant straight away. Madcat just looking over the catwalk, see if he can find something.
Yeah, there was a trade there. Epsilon Swanee got a kill, but he gets taken down by Rox. McMillix takes down Shane. Madcat gets McMillix, and that's a 1v2 situation. Bomb is still not planted, and there's 12 seconds left on the clock.
Absolutely. Madcat, he's coming down the catwalk, just checking it out. Don't think he's got enough time to go to the other flag, to the other bomb site. Oh, wow! Madcat was not expecting that to happen. That was such reactions by Kivi right there. Kivi, a phenomenal player, just picks up that Bison. Madcat just completely caught by surprise by the actions of Kivi right there.
Yeah,
didn't have
enough
time.
Madcat had the height advantage there, literally just jumped out the window. And Kivi's reaction time there, on point.
Absolutely. Madcat just not having the time to get to the A bomb site. Didn't think he'd be able to get the bomb site down quickly enough or cleanly enough on the B site. Decided to challenge Kivi there, and it didn't actually work out in his favour.
Yeah,
what a ball with Jerd.
Didn't work out in his favour, unfortunately. So, jumping on with Jerd, as you just said, Trout. Let's see what he does here. Throws a quick nade. Sees that smoke's down. Doesn't get any reception. No one's eating his grenade today. Just going to change, rotate through, see if any other players are in a better position for some more action.
You know what could be a scumbag idea is just to have all your
idea.
All your teammates on defense just have run double grenades and just, you know, every 10 seconds or so, chuck them onto the bomb site and see what happens. There'd be a lot of grenades. There'd be a very difficult way to get it on the B bomb site.
That's actually you.
If I just had an inspirational idea.
I'm disgusted, but at the same time, I really want to do that.
You think about it, you get like 8 grenades, you get 130, well, yeah. No, 90 seconds, sorry.
Quickie
it's a minute and 30.
Quickie gets a kill onto Shade. Jerd gets a kill onto McMillix, but Kivi is there to clean up Jerd. He is fully tagged, but he needs to get that bomb down. Oh, here comes a nade. No one gets... Kivi doesn't get that. He lives another day. Bomb's going to go down, and now it's up to 2 Epsilon players here to do the work.
Absolutely. Madcat picking up Kivi there. He's still got 2 more members, and he has 1 teammate left alive. That's Swanny going down, actually. So now it's a 2v1 situation. Got 30 seconds left to defuse this. No, he's going to get challenged and put down, equaling it up at 2 all in this search and destroy. And that final kill cam, let's see who it was. It was, in fact, Rox with the MTAR lying in that doorway. Madcat coming running around the corner. I see so many pros just sprinting around corners lately, and they get killed because of it. And, you know, with the AR, you haven't got stalkers. So you need to be a little bit more careful about how you approach things. I know it's crunch time and all, but... it's a hospital thing to do, just running around corners without actually knowing what's around there and getting caught in mid-sprint.
Yeah, sometimes when you're in a rush, you don't really think about it in those situations. But no, just back with Jerd. Let's see how he's going to play this round. It looks like Epsilon are committing to an A push here, but SK are wise to it. Shots going down. Jerd's getting really aggressive here. Can he see someone? Yes, he does.
No. That was a bad idea from them because Jerd had the bomb.
Yeah, he looked like he was trying to get the kill there. It may have been pulled off, but the problem was, even if Jerd did get that kill, there was someone to shoot him in the side, regardless, in back building. So now Shane's really got to think about his next movement here. SK know where the bomb is. It looks like they've all positioned themselves around it to have a look. And there is 45 seconds left on the clock.
Absolutely, we're on board with Shane with the Bison in the middle of the map. He's just going to try and make something happen. They have got a man down. They are very much boxed into this area, so there's no way they're getting out of it cleanly. Shane going to come up the stairs and check if anyone's there. The problem with this hallway is you can't actually see both sides and everything behind it. He does pick up a kill on Rox in the end. Kivi's going to try and challenge him. Shane shuts down Kivi, so now the tables have turned. It's now a 2v2 situation. It was 3-2 a minute ago. Is Magnet going to get shut down?
McMillix gets killed as well. So Epsilon have turned that right round into a 2v1 situation in their favour. And now the bomb's going to be going down with Madcat covering. Madcat is looking in the right direction right now.
Absolutely, he's looking for one of the SK members. He's going to come around the corner. Quick, he picks up Madcat. That was quite interesting. And Swanny, you can never run straight at Swanny in a situation like that because he'll put you down 9 times out of 10, and he does do it on that occasion. So it's going to be 3-2 to Epsilon in this search and destroy with that tracker sight. Does pop round. Picks up an easy kill on Quickie. Quickie just not able to react in any way at all.
Yeah, I don't think he expected Swanny to come around that corner so quick. Otherwise, I don't think Quickie would have been as eager to run down there. Most people say about Swanny, when you get in a long-range gunfight with him, you just don't bother. Just
absolutely. You just
try and survive, run away, and see if you can try and catch him from the side because he is a nuisance at long range.
Put your head down, run. With your tail between your legs pretty much against Swanny in an AR battle at distance because he will beat you every single day of the week. But we're on board with Rox and the SK lineup as they're trying to make a push to the B bomb site once again. They haven't actually made any attempt on the A bomb site at all. And it's been fairly open all these rounds. All teams seem to be predicting that they're going to be going to the B bomb site, and a quick little A rush Could work out wonders for them if they tried it, but Jer just watching on the catwalk. Shane's going to chuck a grenade in as SK do get the bomb down. Jer's on the control panel right now. Shane looking in the back door, just trying to catch someone moving around. Nothing really going to be showing around.
Yeah, nothing concrete is showing up so far. But there's Shane and Madcat with two quick kills there onto Kivi and Quickie. So now all the action's gone off, and Jerd is going to be looking to put that bomb down. Well, I say put it down, looking to defuse it. And he's got halfway up, hasn't he? So the defuse will go down.
Absolutely. One of the SK members actually realizing in what a bad situation he was there, tried to get a jump shot on Jerd defusing the bomb, realizing that if he could stop that, he might be able to delay it just a little bit longer. Doesn't work out. Jerd just goes straight on with the defuse. That's 4-2 now in this Search and Destroy. We're on board with the Epsilon team. Madcat's got that MTAR out. Switching from the Remington. He's going to move on the left-hand side. Once again, looks like it's going to be an all-out push for the B-bomb site.
From that previous round, Trat, it's like when you do get that shot off in a 3v1 situation, you've done enough to kill the bomb defuser. You feel very smug about it because the other two are alive and there's nothing they can do about it. But Kivi got an early nade onto Jerd, so Jerd has been eliminated from this round. 1 minute left on the clock, and Shane's got a bulldog.
Yeah, he's picked up Jerd's bulldog there with a bison to his arsenal. He's going to chuck a grenade over. Quite a few rounds he's done that grenade now, and no one's actually been on the other side. I don't think anyone's really that silly to keep going back there, especially if they did get caught out by a grenade previously. Shane's going to try and go for the bomb plant. There's quite a large area you can actually plant the bombs on this. Kivi's going to pick up a kill there. Madcat's going to answer once again, so they know where the bomb is. Rock's actually coming around the backside, picks up Swanee. Swanee usually able to predict that someone would do that. Madcat with a nice snipe on Quickie there. He's in a 2v1 situation, and he's pincered into this middle hallway.
Oh, he doesn't care. He just runs straight out and gets McMillex. 17 seconds left. Rox is on the other side of the map, and Madcat knows that. So he just gets brave and challenges long range. But you are not making that kill, unfortunately, with an MTAR at range against a Remington. And he just gets outshot.
Yeah, your sub may be flawless, but I don't think it's that flawless to outgun a Remington from that distance and with that amount of cover. But it was a decent try from Madcat. I think he'll be a little bit disappointed he didn't just get on with the objective in that situation. But they're still 4-3 up in the search. Shane is going to be rocking the Bison once again on the defense to see if SK actually make a push for the A-bomb site. But it looks like they're going to be going B once again.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to be going B once again. Shane just positioning himself. And this is where SK have gone every round. So there you go. Strictly business really for SK, isn't it? Rox goes around that corner, doesn't see Shane. Looks like Shane has moved for now, and Rox has just repositioned himself so that if anyone comes up down left stairs, they will get it. And if they go down to the, if they go left or right, they will run into an SK player.
Absolutely. Swanee and Madcat playing a very defensive game right now. They've actually lost one member. I think SK have also lost a member so far. Swanee does pick up a kill on Kivi there. So, in fact, it's going to be a 4-on-2 situation,
four,
my bad.
4-on-3, it's just that on the map, you can see that Shane is on top of Quickie. So, while we're on Shane, his arrow just overlays his. So, it's a 4v3 situation, and we're just, and Shane's just being a patient bear.
Absolutely, just watching that doorway. Kivi and Rox in the bomb site, just making sure that nothing comes out the back. Quickie's looking on the hallway. Shane could be in a bad situation if he's caught out here, but he has moved forward. Does just about pick that kill on Rox. You can see the little bit of lag traces there. Shane has moved right into that building, so the bomb is not going to be going there. Oh, and the knife comes out. Quickie's going to go down for his troubles. That's 5-3 to Epsilon right now. Shane picking up yet another knife kill. Having a fantastic Search and Destroy game right now.
Yeah, there we go. Just puts the knife in Quickie. He gets denied access to computer room. And now it is 5-3. Epsilon are going to be on game point.
Absolutely. Shane 7-6 at the moment, but Madcat 10-5. An incredible slayer he is. Putting in a great performance in the Search and Destroy. Rox 8-4 with the same KD. Kivi 6-7. Not usually used to seeing Kivi, of all people, on a Search and Destroy doing it. You know, he's doing all right. He's not having a fantastic game. I've seen him have better ones, but Swanee 6-4 right now. He does spot someone down there. He's actually going to back off. Madcat's going to try and chuck a grenade up. Shane up on the B-bomb site, just checking it out. Very dispersed lineup the SK guys have here. They're all surrounding them in the middle, but they're not actually making kills, and they're very much in different locations with not a lot of backup to help them out.
Yeah, looking at that bomb, it has backed off from B, so looking for like it may do a rotate. Jer gets a kill on Millet. Shane gets a kill onto Rox. An SK player got a kill onto an Epsilon player, so it's a 3v2 situation. Kivi shuts down Shane. Madcat's looking for Kivi. He gets the cleanup kill, and they are rotating to A. Bomb will go down there. Quickie is left in a 1v2 to keep his team's hopes alive.
Absolutely. Great play by the Epsilon boys to just keep it switched up. I think that's SK's problem. It's been very predictable in this Search and Destroy. Maybe not the one they practice that often.
Yeah,
or bomb. Really they've got a lot of strategies for.
A bomb has gone down, so let's see how quick he plays to keep his team's hopes alive. He finds Jerd. Jerd puts some shots onto him. He has weakened Quickie, so Quickie just like tries to take another route. But when you're on A Street, you are limited in where you can run. So he just runs straight out the front door. Kamikaze run. Runs into Jerd, who cleans him up. And now it's going to be 6-3 to Epsilon. 2-0 up in the series.
Absolutely. Jerd just about picking up the kill. There was a little bit of lag going on there. You can see he couldn't quite put him down, but he does in the end. In case he didn't, Madcat was there with his 11-5. I don't think he would have had much trouble putting him down. But that's going to be 2-0 in the series between Epsilon and SK. Let's see how they get on in the Blitz in the next map. We'll be right back after this commercial break. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to the Gfinity Pro League. My name is Chris Trout, aka the Trout91, and I'm joined by my other half, Calvinus.
I'm not your other half.
Yes, you are. Be quiet. We're watching Epsilon versus SK in this matchup. This is the second fixture of the evening. Well, the second and final fixture, as we saw that TCM versus Vitality will not be going ahead because TCM do not have enough players to play in that game. So we're going to be jumping on with the Blitz game mode now in this best of five series. It's 2-0 to Epsilon, as I said before, and it's Blitz on Warhawk.
Yeah, it is Blitz on Warhawk. Epsilon could close this out, get the 3-0 sweep, and go up 2-0 in our Pro League. Or SK could win this and bring it back to 2-1, give themselves a lifeline, and get back in this series. So, the match is going to begin in 15 seconds. Any predictions, Trout?
I think it's going to be a 3-0 from Epsilon, to be honest. They're such a strong team at the moment. You know how good Shane is at bamboozling the opponents when it comes to objective game modes, so I can see him pulling off some incredibly good portal captures. SK are no slouches when it comes to the Blitz game mode. It was last week that they were 2-0 down against TCM, and they actually came back 3-2 by winning the Blitz and moving forward to win the series. So let's see what these two teams are going to have to throw at each other.
Yeah, let's see what they have to throw at each other indeed. So, jumping on with Kivi, and he is really on goal point, isn't he? He has eyes for it,
yep.
And he gets straight through.
He lets someone completely go there. He saw them on the fence, saw him kill a teammate, just let him go and ran straight for the portal.
Yeah, he did, but we're with Shane, and there you go. He's doing a tag team with his Epsilon teammate, gets in there. Rox gets accidentally team kills Kivi, but he gets his man in the end, and now it is 1-1, and it's only 4 minutes 15.
Absolutely, Madcat just missing the knife on the gate there, but does get through. Eventually, he is in the ambulance garage. He's coming up through the bar. Let's see what he can do.
Yeah, he's going to run someone there. What was that motion? He did like a 360 knife.
Mac Millix picks up that knife. Swanee's going to answer back with the revenge kill. He's going to chuck... I'm not sure if that was a smoke or a stun grenade.
Look at that. He just literally... just twisted Kivi inside out there. Just ran around the tank at the right time. Kivi was... just wondering where he was. Ooh. And he gets the shots onto him, and I like what Swanee's doing here. He just readjusted his aim, aimed it down just in case someone at length did try and come and challenge him, and he gets the kill. But he's waiting for his Epsilon teammates there to come back him up.
Exactly.
which he is doing. But team scored 2-1. Swanee's trying to get some spawn killer going on, but that's not gonna work for him. Teammates are spawning out the gates, but they are in the lead currently.
He was doing a great job there. He got himself in a position where he took all the distract. Oh, Shane with a beautiful double kill there. He did a great job of just distracting the SK lineup, put some shots down, and he had a feeling they would try and re-challenge that. Meanwhile, their entire team was pushing from the left-hand side. SK lineup had no idea what to do. They were too focused on the Swanee, and they managed to get a cap in their favor, and they're actually 3-1 up now. Swanee going an absolute rampage right now. That Swanee, man, has an incredible KD.
Swanee had a little bit of luck there as they ran out of Bakery. He was there prone by tanks, so he blended in a little, turned around, had two SK players just running mid road, had no idea where he was, so he just cleaned them up, and now he is on the offense, and look how far pushed up Epsilon are. But there is an enemy in Epsilon territory, and he's been looking around for ages wondering where they are. Enemy has scored. And now it is 3-2.
Absolutely. Swanee just trying it again. It worked out so well for them last time, and it does work out just about again as Shane gets yet another portal cap. Mackat's going to jump on the lorry. He's going to get shut down by Rox, and Judd and Co are going to come back straight out of it. But I think that might be Kivi. I'm not 100% sure, who just seems to be sneaking in behind the Epsilon lineup. They're so aggressively pushing, and they're getting the portal caps in their favor, but they're not able to defend what SK are bringing to the table.
Yeah, Swanee is on a bit of a tear. 12-4, really putting in some numbers for his team. And you're right, Trout, look at that. This is what is letting them down right now. I think they need a defensive man. They need three. They're doing so well on their attack, they might as well only send three up at this current moment in time, because they are not successfully defending their goal. And now we're on board with Quickie. He's getting slain right now. He's not having the best of first halves, but he has got a point on the board for his team. They're all tied up. That's all that counts. Gets a kill onto Swanee. Rox is 7-3. Just got a little glimpse of him there. But we're going to stay on with Quickie as he's trying to advance to the base. But it's now 6-4. Epsilon are getting up into SK's base, and they're doing a little bit of defense here.
Absolutely, and Quickie just staying alive there, wants to try and get this portal cap. There's only one member left. It is Shane. Is he getting? No, Shane does not get the turn on. They're going to get a portal cap in their favor, and they are now 6-5 behind. And Mac Millick's just trailing behind, waiting for that cooldown reset to happen. He knows that two members there. He's finally killed by Swanee. Swanee's going to get picked up by Kivi. Kivi just about caps it before being taken down. That's 6-6 now. And Quickie as well. He's going to let another Epsilon member go by as he's going to try and cap yet again. And he's going to have a very easy cap there and put the team into the lead with 46 seconds left.
SK are laughing to the bank right now because they've been outslain, yet they're leading.
And Quickie, once again, he's got a great spawn off of the portal cap. He could make this yet 2 points in the lead for them now.
Yeah, and look, again, they think they've trapped SK. They think, oh yeah, I've got the point, but that spawn is allowing SK to just constantly just relay. No one goes down the right side. And Epsilon must be really annoyed right now because it's 6-8 in SK's favor. Yet when the final scores come up, it's just going to look like if it was a if it was a Team Slayer game, for example, which it obviously isn't because they're doing objective work, it would look like SK should be nowhere near the points they're on right now.
Absolutely. I agree completely. And it looks like Epsilon have got a fantastic attacking prowess, but when it comes to defending, they're just non-existent right now. They're just hoping that they don't get by. And that's all they're able to do is just wait for them to pass them and go and cap on the other side because no one is defending.
Yeah, there's the final kill cam. Rox just doing a little bit of defensive work there, stopping Shane from advancing any further. Half time, 6-8, and we're going to be switching sides.
Absolutely. SK going into the second half with a 2-point lead right now. We bring up the scoreboard. Those scores just tell the tale all about Epsilon Swanee right now. But SK winning so far by 2 points.
Yeah, Swanee's putting in some major slaying duties right now. And look at that. Shane, 5-7, but 4 catches for his team. Judd and Madcap with a capture each. And that just tells you, it doesn't matter how good you're slaying right now, as long as your defense is down. Swanee's just putting pot shots all across the smoke, making sure that no one's getting in his base. He prones down there, leaves himself open to Kivi's assault, and enemy scored, but Epsilon do get a point back on the board, and Madcap's coming to do some defense.
Absolutely. It looks like they have turned up their defensive game a little bit. Judd and Madcap both lying on the portal. Maybe not the best idea for them, as Judd's going to come around the left side. Oh my god, what was that for a knife?
A quick knife.
He just knifed him through that like wooden plank.
It's Judd, he just, you know,
he does what he wants.
just knives through wood like it's butter, and he just cleans up Matt Millett. He tried to really step up his aggression there. He gets a kill, but it doesn't really work out for him. Quickie with the long range kill onto Madcap. Battle of the MTARs there. Swanee is in place. He's on 20 kills now, and he's going to be looking to advance, but Millett is there to clean him up. And finally, it looks like they're more defensive minded. That's what it looks like from an Epsilon point of view.
Absolutely. Jurd's coming down the left-hand side. He's going to be met by one of the SK members soon enough. He is going to get killed by Quickie. Madcap coming through the middle, trying to get a jump shot. It's not going to work out, and he's going to back off, and rightly so, as he's going to move through the right-hand side. Actually, he's going to back through the slack jaw, jump on this other, on this ledge, onto the lorry, finally picked up by Rocky, as Jurd, it's very sloppy by Epsilon, their attack now. They had a very organized push going forward before, and now when it comes to attacking, they're all doing it in their single file, and they're just getting killed one after one after one after, and it's just not working out for them.
Yeah, Madcap sticking a knife into Quickie, getting him off there, and now he's really trying to push up, gets another kill onto Kivi, and looking at the mini-map, oh, SK players are dropping like flies right now, but that will just allow them to mount a really good defense here as they'll be pushed back to spawn. Madcap's there, runs into two. Shame runs into Rox, who was prone on the floor, hoping not to be seen. Swanee gets a kill onto Matt Millet, and 2 minutes 30 left on the clock, and this has been a really low-scoring Blitz game.
Absolutely. You can see Swanee getting a little bit fed up with their attacking right now. They've got 2 minutes 30 to bring back those portals, and he's moving up with the team to try and give them a little bit extra gunfire, as they have got someone sitting on the flag. He's actually really well camouflaged with the background of the map, so it can be a little bit difficult to pick him out, especially if you've got other things to prioritize in what you shoot first. And it's just not working out for Epsilon right now. They're really struggling to get out of the gates.
Yeah, really struggling to get out of the gates. There you go. Madcap got the first kill. Looked down the alleyway. Saw a guy on the floor. So he come back round to kill him. And he is really pushing up now. He's going to run into an SK player anytime now. That would be Matt Millet, who was prone on the floor. What Madcap's doing, he's just letting himself be seen a little bit longer while he throws his nades. He's decided not to go up the ladder. And now he's just going to wait
for his team. He's got no support.
Yeah, he's waiting for his team to push up. Jurd and Shane creating a new sort of themselves there. Kivi gets a kill.
Yes.
Either way, an Epsilon player does get in there. Try not to sound biased there, Chris.
It wasn't me being biased. It's the fact that there was so much going on there that they actually managed to get a cap. I'm not biased at all. Not at all.
And here comes... Oh, lag. A little bit of dislag there just as Jurd was trying to run in. But that's... doesn't matter. Well, I say it doesn't matter, but it does matter because he's not in the point. He gets killed, and now SK are really pushing up now. 1 minute left, and they've got Epsilon on the back foot, but Jurd has other ideas. He's really trying to push forward for his team, streaming down pure aggression, and the way it's going right now, it looks like they may trade because an SK player has got through no problem, and he is uncontested running into there, so it's now 8-10. Jurd needs to make that kill. Ooh, he doesn't. Unfortunately, Quickie turned around, got Madcap, then came back for Jurd and got the kill onto him there. But someone has gotten to the point. It's 9-10, 45 seconds left on the clock.
Things really heating up right now. I mean, the end of the first half was 6-8, and now it's 9-10, which is why I was so excited to see a capture actually go in someone's favor. It was such a defensive play by SK to see Epsilon finally break it down. We're at 10-all with 30 seconds left, Cal.
The enemy has scored, so it's now 10-11. Epsilon must be just annoyed right now because they got a point back only for SK to score again, and with 22 seconds on the clock, there's only really one Epsilon player up really for their team, and McMillan slides in there, gets in, scoop free, barely puts any shots down. Madcap looking to get up with Jurd, and even if Epsilon did get a point here, which they do, they're going to lose by 1 point on this blitz.
Disappointing. They had such a good game in the first half. They just couldn't bring the captures to the table. SK did enough to make sure that they won it. They played the objective, not to the kills to death. It worked out in their favor, and it is 2-1 in the series as Epsilon have taken both the domination and search destroy.
I think SK there really did show them how to play defense in that case.
Look at those kills.
Essentially, there was like, well, Swanee, 30 bomb. Madcap, 20 and 17. But they lost at the end of the day, and it was all because of their defense in that first half. Essentially, a player I saw at one point, a player just ran straight down the right side towards B plant, and he didn't check his middle alleyway there, and that's just where I think it was Kivi. When he was relaying, he just came from there straight through, no problem.
It is one of those game modes that unless you check all your corners, you get absolutely punished for it. But
yeah,
that's going to be the end of that. It's 2-1 in the series. Let's see if SK can bring this back or Epsilon can finish it out, as we're going to go into the domination for the next map. But first of all, we're going to have a short commercial break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Oh, hey guys, welcome back to Gfinity. We are going to be going into the fourth map very shortly. We just saw SK take Blitz by 1 point against Epsilon, thanks in part to a little bit of excellent runs from Kivi and Quickie there, and some shoddy defensive work from Epsilon, unfortunately. Absolutely. Now, going into the fourth map, it's going to be Domination again. Just going to be loading up the map. Who do you think will be looking to make an impact here?
I think it's probably going to be very much about Madcap for Epsilon in this one. He is an aggressive player. He's very about the objective, but he's also got a phenomenal aim when he needs to at the longer ranges. But I think when it comes to the SK lineup, when I've seen Kivi play, he's been phenomenal in the close quarter battles, especially on that strike zone. Quickie is no slouch equally. I mean, the whole SK lineup have got some incredible talent in there, so any of them could go off at any point, much like Epsilon. But let's see how it all pans out. Judd and is actually going to ignore the A flag and go straight for the B one with Madcap. They've only got one player from SK moving towards the B flag, and he is not going to challenge it straight away.
Yeah, he's not. I believe there was someone chasing Madcap there. That was Kivi. And there's Quickie to help clean up. Ooh, Epsilon players in B, which means that Madcap's going to be doing some defensive work on A. Just gets that player away from his A flag, and SK are going to get B.
Absolutely, and we're on board with Shane. Actually, a really bad stun grenade thrown out there, but he's going to chuck a 7. Try and pick up this kill. I think he does, in fact, get it. As I was checking the scoreboard there, Rox is going to get taken down. And it looks like Quickie's going to move for the kitchen to try and make something happen here. They are two flags down right now. Does get a drop shot on Judd. Two Epsilon members coming through the front door of B. He's just going to wait a little bit and see if anything else challenges for the kitchen. Rox is actually coming around the backside to A. He picks up a kill on Shane. None of the Epsilon members really there to make something happen. There are two SK members in the kitchen.
Yeah, there are two SK members in the kitchen. Now we're in bar with Kivi, and Rox is on A. He's looking to take A away from Epsilon, which he does successfully, but Epsilon have got C. So essentially it's just the same, just flags have just changed around a little there. And we're on board with Milletz. He just sees one of his teammates get slain there, and I don't think he wants none of that. He wants Quickie get slain now, and he gets cleaned up as well. So that was a nice little free piece for Shane. Just gave them all just...
I can't even jump on board with him. He's dead.
Yeah, unfortunately, he's dead after all that effort. But nice little showing from him. It was all just... it's like watching a bad movie, you know, when you see seeing a horror film. Your teammate goes around the corner, absolutely, he's dead. And Shane gets the Semtex, but gets cleaned up by Quickie. We're jumping on with Judd. C flag has gone into SK's control. And Epsilon will be looking to do something about it. Again, essentially, he's rotated. 33-27. SK opened up a little bit of a lead here, and Swanny's going to be looking to take C for his team.
Absolutely. Joe going to come in the kitchen, gets a nice kill on Quickie. He's going to back off through the overlook and check on the C flag, as one of his teammates is going to be capping that C flag. He's just going to give him a little bit of cover. It is Swanny, in fact. Swanny goes down. Rox picks up two kills there on both Judd and Swanny in that one. Shane picks up a kill on Quickie in return. They're actually two flags down right now. Very even scores so far. This map is not all about the strategies. It does help to have one, but it is all about your raw slaying power, and considering the connections of some of the players in this, I think it's going to be very much in the favor of SK. As Swanny picks up a kill, him having to get down and dirty with it, as Kivi picks up a kill on Judd, and Madcap just kills going all over the board right now.
Yeah, it's tied up 43-43, and it's just, yeah, it really is a slay fest right now. When you look at the map, because we're mainly focused on Epsilon, when you see them get a kill, there's an SK player there that comes clutch, you know, gets them off the flag. So the most Epsilon are getting right now is a neutralization. And now it is 47-51, so SK are jumping into the lead with just under 2 minutes left on the clock. We're on board with Rox. He gets a MTAR kill onto Madcap. Going in pro shot, looking for someone else. He does get Swanny, but Judd is the final player to clean him up. Kivi's full red, but he's not going to let that stop him. Gets a kill onto Shane, runs into Madcap, unfortunately. And you can see Epsilon are now taking C. But what that's going to do is give SK just legal right to go run over at A. They try and get the point, but there's a player there trying to make a nuisance of himself. And you can see Quickie is just doing a little bit of defensive work by B.
Absolutely. We're on board with Kivi right now. He's actually going to go down straight away. And Rox as well going down. Swanny picks up two kills in that battle. Quickie's capping the C flag for his team. They still have the B flag. Great kill on Shane, but Swanny's going to answer back on Quickie. He's going to jump on the flag and try and make something happen. Actually, he's going to back off and neutralize it. just kills it all over the place. Let's find someone to stick on ball where Quickie just picks up a kill on Swanee. Gonna go through the pro shop. Kivi's gonna actually make a battle go on here. He's gonna move to the B flag as the Epsilon boys are spawning on it. They're going to come around to the C flag. A knife by Kivi there. And he picks up the second knife in a row. MacMillan's actually team kills Kivi. He must have been so happy with it that he got a little bit trigger happy and picked up a kill on his own teammate.
MacMillan's is like, Kivi, man, you're getting a little too excited there. Calm down. Respawn in five. And that just means that they've, well, lost B in the end. They could have may have taken it there if they were both two players up. But we're back with Quickie, and he is just overseeing A while his teammate takes it. Jez got other ideas. They stop the A flag being taken. But there's another SK player there. That is Quickie with a two-piece on Jern and Swanee, but Madcat is there to clean it up. So just going into the half, it looks like Epsilon are going to lead on this side, but not by much. It's just coming in now 80-75 when the round closes. And that was a really close round, Trout.
Absolutely. Madcat giving them the big ting right at the end just to give them that 5-point lead and make sure they have something to go forward in this map.
For those people that are not from London, could you explain to them what the big ting is?
I don't need to explain the big ting. The big ting is the big ting.
See, it wasn't me who said it was the big ting. So that's fine with me. Shane 16-12. Madcat 14-9 with one capture. Jared was the man who done the most captures for his team. 9-8, three captures. Swanee equal 10-10 with a capture.
You can tell that Jern not particularly 100% comfortable right now. There were moments when I think he was a little bit... He almost knew he was going to die. I think he's feeling the woes of the connection a little bit too much right now. Simply because you saw an opportunity there where he tried to pick up a kill, chucked the grenade, and he had flak jacket, and then when he tried to challenge, he just didn't really know what to do with himself because he was sure he was going to lose that gunfight.
Yeah, potentially. I think Jared doesn't feel as comfortable on this game as he did on Black Ops 2, but I'm going to give that man another month.
Yeah.
And then he should be back to old ways very soon.
Black Ops 2 was one of those games that it was almost coded to be a little bit spongy when it came to shots. You could like take bullets for days and still get out of there alive. And on this game, if you've been seen, you're pretty much dead 100% of the time. Well, I say 100, more like 90% of the time. But it's very rare you see players get away with being shot at and surviving to live another day. Let's actually see how these teams work out. Two pieces,
pretty much the new three piece on this game.
Pretty much.
So if you get four, you are considered something special. Madcat just touches C a little bit to help his team there. But look at Judge, straight out the bat, we're talking about him. He gets two kills straight away.
Don't mind me.
Swanee gets a kill onto Quickie, so essentially only one SK player is allowed to do something about it. But it is MacMillan. He team kills Kivi just to get to Madcat. He's on a mission. Rotz gets onto Shane, and now he is running down the side of Pro Shot by statue looking to get C.
Absolutely. Rox is taking a C flag. His teammate's taking an A flag. This could be a very early triple cap. Sorry, not a triple cap. This could be a very early start for the Epsilon boys. They're making great slaying power right now. SK actually locked into the B flag. They're going to lose the A flag as well. So it's up to Epsilon to try and lock him in there. They're doing a great job of making kills. Swanee picks up two. Can he pick up a third? Yes, he does pick up the third kill on Kivi. Great play by Epsilon right now. They are having a tremendous start to this domination. Swanee finally shut down on a five kill streak. And Epsilon just starting to move away with this.
Yeah, I think Epsilon finally starting to gather where SK are spawning and are just adjusting accordingly. But SK are out. They are going by A and it looks like they're going to take it because they have two players there, which they do. Shane throws a nade in there, hits someone with flat jacket. Milix gets a knife onto Madcat up in middle. And Shane's just looking for someone. Finds someone there. It's Kivi. Gets a few shots on, but that's not enough. Kivi did get first shot. And they're swanning to clean it up. And he's just going to be patient. Going to wait a little while. Yeah, he waits for his teammate to come, Swanee, and it looks like two of them are going to attempt to take A here.
Absolutely, Jared coming around this corner, doesn't spot anyone there. He's going to try and move to the... No, he's going to make sure no one comes to the A flag, try and lock him in that B flag. They need to get set up, though. It looks like one's gone AWOL right now. Quickie picking up two important kills. Kivi answers back on Shane, so that's three down for Epsilon. Now they need to make a push as they pretty much put the entire Epsilon team down with a great burst of energy. It looks like SK are come roaring back into this game.
Yeah, they broke out of there successfully and got quite a bit of map control here. And as you can see, there's one SK player doing defense by B, another one doing defense by A pretty much. So they're just waiting for it. And Quickie's the one just roaming around, providing a nuisance of himself. They know they got a two cap and they just got to hold it, really. So it's 33-30, and it's all to play for still.
Absolutely. SK doing a great job. They are 4 points in the lead for this round overall. They're now equaling it overall cumulatively over the two halves. With 2 minutes 30 left, if they can hold on to this capture, they can take the round and take it to a final map, which will be Search and Destroy on Freitas. Rocks just wins that duel against Jerd. Not very often you see Jerd losing a one-on-one duel like that. Quickie picks up a kill on Madcat. Swanee answering back on Mac Millix. Shane again picking up a kill on Quickie. Kivi answers back on Shane. So many trades going down, and they're going to try and pick up their A flag as Rox is going to come onto the overlook. Just check, nothing's happening. He's finally taken down. Madcat looks like he wants to take this B flag. He's actually going to jump over someone who's sitting on the booth there.
Punishment time.
Oh, and he hasn't seen him. A Quickie picks up a double kill, just holding onto that B flag. That's surely going to be one that they're going to be kicking themselves over.
If they watch that kill count back, Madcat will be very annoyed with himself for not seeing that player. But there you go, sometimes it does happen. Kivi gets a double. McMillix gets a kill onto Madcat. McMillix gets a double of his own. Four of Epsilon down. They're going to be coming off the respawn. And SK are pushing, are breaking away now. 57 to 48. Still very close. They can go either way. There's 1 minute 30 left on the board, but it's plus 5 to SK right now.
Absolutely. They're doing a great job of just holding on to this lead with a minute 20 on the clock. Kivi and co have got the A and B flag. They're actually losing the B flag. Rots challenging in there. Put some shots down. Sorry about that. Kivi going to get shut down by Jerd with an amazing two-piece. Gets the third in the end on Quickie. Great play. Mac Millix left alive. Does pick up a kill on Swanee. He's going to try and neutralize this C-flag and stop them and break the things up a little bit. Make sure that they don't lose this lead that they have. They have got about 11 points in their favor right now. Shane trying to challenge on the C-flag. It's not going to happen. They're going to pick up another flag with 45 seconds left on the clock. They are, in fact, 11 points in the lead. Well, sorry, not 11. They are 6. That's going to be 7 points in the lead.
Yeah, 73 to 61. 36 seconds left on the clock. So some big players need to come out now. Jerd is on A. His teammate has... Well, I was going to say his teammate was on B, but no, that was an SK player, which means that Epsilon have lost bar side. And now, and as you can see, the SK players are popping off right now. All the kill feed is SK. Rocks with a double kill view with a third onto Shane. Madcat answers back with a kill onto Kivi. But with this time left, I think it's a little too late now. SK have won this map.
Absolutely. A couple kills that didn't go in Epsilon's favor. They made the kills they needed, but not the ones that mattered overall, as they lost out on that C flag, which could have been crucial in the end in deciding this round. And it looks like we are going to go to a final map with Search and Destroy on Freight.
Yeah, then SK winning by plus 22 on this side. If you take away Epsilon's plus 5 there, SK plus 17. Which means they have won the fourth map, Domination Strike Zone, and we will be going to Search and Destroy on Freight.
Absolutely, and that map will be coming very shortly. We've already had a best of five go all the way between Aware and Meet Your Makers. Aware taking the victory in that one. Let's see how it's going to fare out with Epsilon and SK. Both teams having a win in their arsenal right now. We'll be right back after this commercial break to conclude this game. Hello and welcome back to the Gfinity Pro League. My name is Chris Trout, aka the Trout91, and I'm joined by Calvin, and we are commentating the Epsilon versus SK game. It has gone to 2-2. It is the decider right now. Freight, Search and Destroy.
You have no voice.
I know, it's going. I need to sort it out.
go get some night nurse in your life.
Some night nurse. I don't think that's gonna solve this. But we're on board right now for the final decider. Both these teams having a win in their locker. The winner of this will most likely determine who tops the leaderboards, to be honest.
Well, they'll be pretty much equal with Aware now because they won their series 3-2. So, we're going to see how this is going to play out. We've got Shane here. He's got an MTAR and a sniper rifle. using the MTAR to just gain a little speed there. Whips out the L115, looking to see if he can pick off any potential victims here. But he doesn't see anyone. There's no one on the map right now. And we're just going to wait for this to play out.
Absolutely. Frey is a very... what's the word I want to use here to describe this map? Dull. Very dull map for a minute, and then it's 30 seconds of chaos, I found, in most cases. It looks like a lot of players are still feeling the map out. They're not too sure on how to approach the map itself, and it creates for a lot of second guessing and very slow pushes.
Yeah, Jer just noticed a flash next to him there, and he's just going to investigate that. Looks like, and yep, there you go, speculative nade pays off. He saw the flash from McMillix's gun, throws a nade over there, gets the kill. And now we're hopping on with Shane. He's just doing a little bit of prone work down by the train tracks.
Oh,
that vault has just robbed him of a potential kill there. But there's Jerd. He gets fully tagged up by Kivi. That bomb is not going to go down today. But Shane answers back with a kill onto Quickie. They need to find Kivi. Otherwise, it'll be Swanny who's going to get shot next. Wait, he does not. Bomb has gone down, tries to run away, but he has been tagged up a little. But he does get away to fight another day. Ooh, he does see that player. Put some shots down, backs up. But that SK player will have a rough idea where he is. But it's a 3v1 situation. That player gets cleaned up by Swanny. And now Epsilon got 1-0 on the map.
Absolutely. It's great play by the Epsilon guys there. Swanny decided to go for the plant. Once again, catching him out of position, off guard, and... I think it was Madcat was actually just putting down fire on that building just to make sure that they couldn't actually shoot through the wall on Swanny. I think it's very important to note that on this map, if you plant on the A bomb site, you can actually hear them through the wall and get the kill that you need to, which is also why it creates for such a delayed and slow push. But there's also a lot of things you can do differently. I think it's one of those maps that you kind of have to have a premeditated idea of how you want to attack it. You can't just sit there and wait for picks to happen, because you can get in positions like Swanny is currently in that just see that A bomb site, and it's one of the few bomb sites that, you know, there's no reason why you wouldn't go to it. It's right in front of you, and getting to the B bomb site is so much hassle and so much more of a difficult task that you would naturally just go to that A bomb site.
Yeah, Quickie is on bomb site A. He hasn't actually got the bomb, but that attracts Swanny's attention. He gets the kill down there. Swanny's going to be waiting, looking to see if anyone else is going to pop by A. That's an excellent vantage point, pretty much. Shane's just looking mid-road, looking to see if he has anybody. Jer's going to be sitting on the left. Madcat gets a kill down in mid. So now SK are two players down, and with 24 seconds left on the clock. Bomb is down as well.
Absolutely. Rox is on this left-hand side. He's got that Remington out with the grip. Oh, he's going to get shut down by Madcat. Swanny's still up in his vantage point. He's surely going to see one of the players. No, it's going to be picked up by one of the other Epsilon members as they move 2-0 up in this search and destroy. Let's see who picked up that final kill. It was, in fact, Jerd picking it up. Quite a few Remingtons coming out from the Epsilon guys right now. Quite surprised to see Shane using a sniper rifle as well.
Yeah, they realised the importance of long-range gun battles in this map. And we're going to be switching sides. Well, the importance is that they have the height advantage on the side that they're on. So they have a little bit of breathing room to use long-range weapons. Going to be jumping on with Kivi, who has a Remington of his own. And he'll be looking to just get some entry kills here alongside with Quickie.
Absolutely. And Quickie's going to stop short of the A-bomb. Just make sure no one comes charging through for it. MacMillan's actually in a great position right there. Grenade almost kills him, so he's got to try and get out of there as soon as possible. He's going to chuck the smoke to aid him in that. But Jerd gets a great grenade on MacMillan in the end. That's going to give him a great little advantage to move forward and make something happen. Shane just looking over and make sure no one's coming from the middle. Going to jump on the right side. Quickie picks him up in the end. Kivi up on the top. Picks off Jerd, who's left stranded. It's up to Madcat and Swanny to make something happen. The two of the most amazing AR players in Europe at the moment. Madcat just checking. Nothing coming from the right-hand side. Swanny checking the left. They're going to make an organized push. A grenade comes out just to give them a little bit more room to push forward. But they still are split up. Possibly not the best idea right now.
Yeah, you just saw a player run there that has attracted Quickie. He's just going to readjust himself to make sure no one's coming on his left side. But if you look at that Epsilon player, he's run straight through the mat. He'll be running to middle. Probably Quickie has called that out to his teammate. Swanny's fully tagged. Kivi kills Madcat. So Swanny's left with it all to do in a 1v3. Gets one. And he's got 7 seconds left on the board, so it's not going to go off right now. And he's going to run into Quickie very soon. Yes, he does. Gets taken down, and it is 2-1.
Absolutely. SK just playing a very good, solid defense. Madcap made a great push into that building, and he could have made something happen, but we didn't actually get to see what happened in that building, but he did get taken down. It wouldn't surprise me if he was caught in mid-sprint once again with an AR, which is not going to be great for his team, as they are 2-1 up still in this search and destroy, and they are on the defense, and as we saw in the previous round, they did have such a strong defensive setup.
Yeah, Swanny putting shots down on that ladder because he's going to be looking to go and get some height advantage. McMillitz gets a kill onto Jerda, so Swanny will be waiting. And here comes the nade. Is McMillitz going to die? Oh. No, he's not. I think Kivi just saved McMillitz's bacon there by getting that kill. And it has allowed McMillitz to just push in on that middle building. So now it is SK with 4 men up and they have to just plant the bomb.
Well, Quickie missing a snipe there on someone in the middle. They're both together right now, and they are on the defense. So even though SK have the advantage right now, they still got to put down the bomb. Kivi actually picking up Swanee's weapon, the Remington with the tracker sight. Kivi still up on that top building. Quickie up on the crates. They've got to put the bomb down right now on that A bomb site. Rox is going to finally go and make a move for it with 30 seconds left on the clock. The plant is going to go down. Shane runs out. He's shut down. There's one more member of the Epsilon lineup right now. And it's 4 people for SK up. Madcap picks up McMillitz. Can he do the impossible? Let's have a look. Is he going to pick up a kill? He does pick up a kill on Rox and just gets out of there. Is he going to challenge again? He does challenge again. Didn't have a good line of sight on him. He is going to get caught out. He should have just backed off in that situation. But unfortunately for him, he does challenge and he does get caught out.
If he didn't sprint round that corner, he may have had a fighting chance against Kivi there, as he did not get tagged by the second SK player. But 2-2, all tied up now, and both teams are 4 rounds away from winning.
Yeah, it does look like Madcap has been caught out a number of times by mid-sprint, and it's something that he maybe should think about in the future games to not actually do it as often, as it has got him killed quite a lot of the time. And we're going to see Quickie just watching this left-hand side. Very defensive setups from both teams. Let's see who's going to make the first move as McMillix is watching that side. Epsilon Swanee with the Thermal Remington just watching the middle. We've got the bomb carrier. That is Jerd, I believe, on the sticks with the Remington. Just checking left-hand side. They want to make a move into that middle building, but Jerd's going to get shut down by McMillix. Kivi putting some shots down just to make sure no one follows it up. Very defensive setup from the SK lineup.
And rightfully so. They have no reason to be venturing around in places they don't need to be. Shane does a little bit of exploring, but he finds Rox, who shuts him down. And now we're on with Kivi. 4v2 situation in favor of SK. They've really got some momentum in this S&D. Now they're looking to take their third straight round. 25 seconds left on the clock. And all they need to do is either wait for the bomb plant, but you can see that they're well positioned to deny an A and B push. Kivi has taken down Madcap. Swanee's the last one with the bomb. He should see someone on that head glitch. He does not, and he's going to get shot.
Yeah, Epsilon just letting it slip now. They were 2-0 up, and now they are down 3-2. Great performances from the SK guys. Swanee just not actually seeing him. I'm not too sure how he didn't, because me and you saw him plain as day. And you would imagine that someone sits there, because every time I've watched a freight search and destroy, someone has been on that little jump up area there. I'm not even sure what to call that, but we're going to jump on board with McMillix with the Thermal. Quickie is moving on this left hand side with the Thermal L116. Let's see what he can pick up. Counter to that, we see Swanee and Jerd in this middle building. Kivi's gone very aggressive right here to try and make something happen. Swanee picks up an early kill on Kivi.
Yeah, Kivi got a little too aggressive there, and his punishment is death. And now another SK player got taken down early. Well, no, he didn't actually. It's a bomb carrier was masking his other teammate, so it's a 4v3 situation. McMillitz is looking to tie it up.
Absolutely. McMillitz, he's at... Oh, no, he hasn't seen someone. Thought he saw someone for a second there, but they're all in the buildings. Just using every nook and cranny he can to get an advantage or a pick on someone, but as we've seen in the past defensive lineups, Epsilon have been sitting in the buildings, and they are doing that once again. They've got 30 seconds to make something happen now. Shane picks up Quickie. Swanee picks up Rox. And Mad Cat is going to finish up. Or was that actually Swanee there who picked it up? But Mad Cat and Swanee. Yeah, it was Mad Cat.
It was Mad Cat with the final kill onto McMillitz. Just sees him poke out from beyond the trains and gets the shot off onto him.
Absolutely fantastic aim by him. Incredibly difficult setup to break there from the Epsilon lineup. Leveling it up at 3-all now as we start this next round. Epsilon going to be on the attack this time. Let's see what they can bring out. Bring something a little bit more inventive to the table, as it's been a very stale standoff in the Search and Destroy map so far. Jerd's actually going straight for the A bomb site. This is so aggressive. And Quickie's not even aware that that man is there. Shane does go down, but it's going to let Jerd know that someone is there. He's going to back off as they do get that bomb down. Is this going to be an early defuse from the SK lineup?
Yeah, defuse is on right now. So Jerd is going to have to take a look at rightfully so. Yes, he does. He gets the kill onto Rots. Look at that. The hit and run has been successful. But he doesn't know that there's someone behind who came from underground. But there is Mad Cat. Just wait a little bit of time. Nade has been thrown over.
A little bit early.
A little bit early. But there he goes in a 2v1 situation. Oh, and Kivi gets the kill. So the defuse is going to go down and SK foil Epsilon's early bomb plant plans.
Yeah, Mad Cat had the idea there of chucking the grenade, did it a little bit too early in that situation, and then jumped out a little bit unnecessary, put himself in a bad situation. Situation with no cover, not much he can do from a position like that as well, and the guys just collapsed on him, picked up the kill, picked up the defuse. I liked what I saw there from Epsilon, but the execution didn't go all the way.
Yeah, the execution did not pay off. And we're just going to jump on with McMillix, see how he's going to play this round. It is 4-3 in favor of SK. They'll be looking to gain the next two rounds and close this series out.
Absolutely, McMillix is... this is a counter quick plant from the SK guys.
SK are sharing that if you can quick plant, so can we. And the bomb has gone down, so this is going to be a mighty quick round here.
I don't think they're aware that Swanee is still up in that building. He could pop out and pick up a kill. Kivi picks up Jerd there. Swanee still patrolling on that building. Quickie lying down on the bomb. Rocks on the other side. Swanee checking this back door. He's convinced someone is coming there. Shane picks up a kill. Quickie asks his back on Shane. Madcat picks up Quickie. Kivi trying to pick up Swanee here. He's going to run out of bullets and back off.
Yeah, he needs to get that reload down. But he's got... Well, he's got more important Madcat plans. Kivi gets the kill onto Swanee.
Oh.
I was going to say, Matt Kivi had more important plans there. I thought he was just going to leave Swanee alone and go after the defuser. But SK played out this round very well. It is 3-5, and they have just completely taken this game into their hands.
Absolutely. A little bit of miscommunication from the Epsilon guys. They couldn't make their mind up what to do. Looks like Swanee was just going to sit there. Madcat tried to ninja defuse, and they're 5-3 down after being two maps up. They are 5-3 down in the final map of this series against SK.
Yeah, they're gonna, if they lose this, they can bring it to around 11. All they need to, but they need to win 3 straight rounds now. Otherwise, they will just lose them. They'll lose their first game of the Pro League, and it will be in spectacular fashion after going 2-0 up. There's Swanee, gets some shots down. Ooh. There. He kills Kivi, gets the entry kill. That is first blood, and we're gonna be looking at Maka as he sees that on the ground door has been open. He doesn't like that.
Just checking that no one's coming through there. He's going to shut it and see what his teammates can make happen. They are 4-3 right now, so they've got all the advantage. One of the SK members actually coming back through that underground. Surely they're going to hear that he's coming through. And in fact, Madcat does hear it, and he's going to turn around just to check what's happening. But he's going to lurk around. Jerd with the bomb, just checking no one is up in that top freight building.
McMillix actually got through there. He got the kill onto Madcat. Quickie gets the kill onto Shane. It is a 2v3 situation, and there is 25 seconds left on the board. So we're going to see how Epsilon play this. The aggression is going to be unreal now.
Absolutely. Swanee in this freight building. One of his favorite buildings. It looks like, always, he's going to pick up Rocks there.
Yeah,
there's another member outside.
Looking at the underground, McMillix looked like he came behind Jerd. Should have got the shot off there, but he didn't. And now the plant is going to go down. It has to go down. There is no choice. And he does it with 0.2 remaining. So now Jerd is just going to wait on that head glitch, wait for McMillix to challenge him. And he's in a good fighting position right now. And Swanee is there to back him up as well on the right, on his left.
It's a great position. Jerd just got so much cover to aim at. He does pick up McMillix through the wall there. And if someone comes from the other side, Swanee's surely going to pick up the kill. They know Jerd is there. It's alerted him. Quickie's going to pick up Jerb, but surely Swanee can make something happen here. He does with the AR. Never, never doubt Swanee in a situation like that. It's 5-4 right now. Let's see what SK have to do to shut this out. And Epsilon behind. They need to win two rounds to make sure they don't embarrass themselves after being 2-0 up in the series.
Yeah, that's right. And now we're going to go on board with Epsilon and just see if they can bring it back to 5-5. 1 minute 30 on our search and destroy round. So we're going to see how this is going to pop off. As you say, Trout, the first minute of freight generally is typically boring. But let's see if this is going to be changed. If you saw the stats right there, you would have seen that Kivi is doing a lot of work for SK. He is on 11-5 right now.
Yeah, he had a bit of a stinker in the first Search and Destroy. He's bringing it back, the Kivi I'm used to seeing on a Search and Destroy. Swanee just making sure no one goes for the plant on the A-bomb site. We've got to imagine that's where they're going. And they don't want to give any advantage to SK right now. As all they've got to do is win one round. So they're pretty much just sitting there waiting for them to make the move. They are in defense. Very smart move from them to just wait to see what SK bring up. Kivi's going to try and get a little bit sneaky here and jump on the building.
Yeah, he's looking for Swanee. He knows that Swanee likes to be there. And if you look at that, statistically, Swanee should win this gunfight if he pops around at the right time. There you go.
There
he does pop around. Swanee gets the kill. Swanee gets two. And the bomb is in Swanee's view, roughly, with 23 seconds left on the clock. This is all for SK to just try and get some kills here. Gets one onto Madcat, but they still need to get the bomb and get it planted. And the way Swanee's positioned,
he can see them. Oh, it's like they're running out for the slaughter.
There is Swanee with his third. He'll be looking for the final kill here. And he knows that the bomb must be around it because all three SK players have just looked around there so far.
Oh, Swanee gets the ace. I don't think I've ever seen someone get an ace without moving more than 5 yards.
Yeah, Swanee with the ace tags him up with Jerd. Jerd didn't even really get a shot there. And yep, 5-5. Swanee with an ace. He's on. I think he's on 13-5 right now. So it's all to play
time.
For. One more round.
This is match point right here. Winner of this will get 3 points towards the Pro League. The winner of the Pro League indeed getting a grand in the bank for his team. It's all to play for. SK making a more aggressive push up, but they have slowed down. And Epsilon have the advantage here, being on the defense, getting the most kills.
Quick plant.
Quick plant going down by Macmillix. I don't think Epsilon are aware of this. They're nowhere to really answer. Swanee's in a position, but they are.
Swanee should have. Swanee couldn't see him, must have been, because he's gotten away with that. And now, 35 seconds are left on the clock, and as you can see by the positioning, no one is really making the move right now. It's all to play for. Swanee's putting shots down. He's killed Rox, but Rox has killed Shane, so it's a 3v3. Quickie's down by the blue.
It's too slow by Epsilon. They've got to make a move
now. Yeah, they do. They're going to be leaving it sloppily to the last minute, but here we go. They've pincered Macmillix. Kivi gets a kill there. Quickie gets a kill, and it is left up to, I believe, it's Swanee, and
he gets taken
down as well, and that is 6-5. SK must be feeling pretty good about themselves because they brought it back to round 11, and they have won the series outright 3-2.
Wow, I can't believe Epsilon have lost that. 2-0 up in the series. And they've lost 3-2 to SK. The guys from Germany have become victorious over Epsilon right here.
And yeah, 14-6 for Swanee there. And I believe Kivi got 12-6 as well. So good showings by both players. But as it stands, it means that SK should be going near the top of the table. Probably going up to, I'd say, just below aware maybe.
Absolutely. And let's get a look at the results from today's fixtures up on your screen for you, as we see that it was in fact Epsilon who just lost to SK Gaming, the game you've just seen 3-2. If you missed it earlier, Aware Gaming won 3-2 against Meet Your Makers. It was another 5-game thriller. Unfortunately, Vitality versus TCM will not be taking part because TCM had to drop out due to a player forfeit, not being able to turn up for the game. So they've had to forfeit and they have been defaulted the win 3-0 in the end. It's a shame that we can't show that game. It would have been an incredible matchup. I've seen Vitality and TCM play before, and it is so exciting to watch. So much, you know, so much is on the line when those two teams come to play.
Yeah, that is very true. And, well, this will be it for today's Pro League sessions, seeing as we cannot get Vitality and TCM, unfortunately, as you said.
It is a shame.
So, join us next time. on mlg.tv/gfinity. We will have more games for you from the Pro League, and we'll hope to see you soon.
Yeah, just before we go, let's get a quick look at the league standings right now, just to see how it is all panning out after this second round of fixtures. Aware and SK Gaming both at the top there. Aware just on top by a round difference of 2, as they won 3-0 against Vitality last week. SK Gaming coming back 2 weeks in, well, 2 rounds in a row of fixtures, you know, being 2-0 down, winning 3-2 in the end. Epsilon having 1 win and 1 loss. Team Vitality getting that win by default, losing last week to Aware Gaming. Meat Makers unfortunately losing 2 games in a row. TCM losing that heartbreaking loss to SK Gaming last week and getting their forfeit. So that's going to be it from us here at Gfinity for the Pro League. Make sure you join us on Monday for the next round of fixtures. It is going to be an incredible clash of games. I've been Chris Trout, aka the Trout91. This has been Calvin, aka Calvinus. And we've had Bryce here in the studio, but he's gone off to do other things. So we'll hopefully have him back in the studio on Monday. And we'll see you for then. I hope you've enjoyed it this evening. I'll see you later.